Now we're going to talk about the two different ways we can establish a plane when measuring a horizontal surface here. One of the methods is provided with the machine in the kit. They're using our plane blocks. You'll notice on these plane blocks, there's a red arrow pointing up at the top horizontal line here. What we're going to want to do is take three of these blocks out, and we're going to want to stand them up so that arrow is pointing straight up into the sky. Now we're going to want to spread these out as far as we can on whatever size or shape we have in front of us that we're going to template here. So I'm going to take my first one and set it up on the left front corner of our cabinets here. Then I'm going to take my right one and set it up on the right front edge of the cabinets. And then I'm going to take my back one and set it up on the cabinet edge up against the wall there. Now we're going to take our laser and we're going to aim exactly onto the top horizontal line here. Shoot a point for the left. We're going to aim onto the top horizontal line over here and shoot a point for our right. And then we're going to aim on the top horizontal line here and shoot a point for our back. When we use the blocks here, we're establishing a plane that is matching the surface that the carpenters gave us in space here. Whether this is level or not, we're matching that plane with these blocks here. So the other method we can use is using our self-leveling laser. So with this device here, we can turn this guy on, set it up on one end of our cabinet run here, and now you see this is projecting a perfectly level laser line in our whole kitchen right here. So what we can do is actually take our 2D, 3D laser and aim right onto the laser line over here and shoot our left. We could aim right onto the laser line over here and shoot our right. And then we can aim right onto the laser line and shoot our back point here near the back corner. Now, when we use this self-leveling laser, we're creating a plane that's perfectly level in space here. So the reason why both these methods work is because we're either matching the surface that the carpenter provided for us, or we're perfectly level. Because what happens with this plane, once you establish this plane floating in space here, when we shoot down on the front cabinet face, it moves that point up through space at a perfect 90 degree angle to the plane. And when we shoot on the back wall here, it's gonna move that point down through space at a perfect 90 degree angle to our plane there. As a general rule of thumb, I do not want you to take points more than 6 inches below or 6 inches above the plane that we establish here. Why we wanna follow that rule is because we know that these walls are not plumb, nor are they flat. We also know these cabinets can be out of plumb and out of level as well. So if you decided to shoot your point up here on the wall and that wall has mud on it floated out a quarter inch, and that's where you decided to do your scribe, it's going to take that point and move it down through space at a perfect 90 degree angle to our plane that was floated out a quarter inch. When you take your tape measure over here, you're going to be a quarter inch off all day, every day, because you didn't shoot your points where your stone is actually going to exist at in space. So the key here is staying closer to where our stone is actually going to exist at, the better.